This is KTN News.
He doesn't understand why governors are not implementing this CBA. He thought this should have been dealt with a long time ago.
Oh, okay. Actually, we need to be clear. There is no CBA yet. Okay. But there's a negotiation.
Why haven't you signed it? That's what he's asking.
Yeah, actually, where it's not been signed, I think, and I mentioned this, it's quite clear. When you crunch the numbers, counties do not have that money, the employers. And secondly, that's it. They do not have the money. When you crunch those numbers as in that draft, in the negotiation draft, it comes to 40 billion for the 4 years.
49 billion.
Yeah. Now you may say it's 49 billion. So this is 214 million per county every year just for nurses. And remember, in healthcare, we have several components. So 70%, as it stands now, 70% of allocation of counties in healthcare goes to remuneration of healthcare workers. If we do this, we might increase it to 85% or something. And that begs the question, then, what do we do with issues like commodities? What do you do issues with, like, maintenance of these facilities?
So then what was guiding the governors when they were negotiating in the first place?
Yes. I mean, as I said, negotiations are held where numbers are put on the table.
But the numbers were there.
Just to give it into perspective, that SRC clearly stated, you know, SRC has given guidelines. Before we accept, the no objection letter.
Yeah.
Proof. And that's why we are saying we are working with the numbers, and we are saying, let's see to the union, let's prove to
which
SRC. Let's come with numbers that we can say we've proven, and if not only proven, we've shown it's sustainable.
But I mean,
can I give the numbers here?
What, bank numbers or people numbers? Because numbers are not a problem for us.
No.
The teachers are about 100,000.
Or the money numbers. I think, let's put into perspective. The total national budget, please note, the total national budget is 4% of GDP without the county allocations. Mm-hmm. That's number one. So we do have the monies and everything else. Number two, in 2016, NHIF collected 35 billion from the contributor. Who are just the people who are not, the population that was...
But we know that the majority of the NHIF goes to paying private hospitals, for instance.
No. What was paid in hospitals, including those who go to India, is 15 billion.
Yeah. So there's money.
Actually,
the question of money is not there. It's a question of...
Mr. Laibuta has a response.
Allow me to respond. I think I mentioned this before when I mentioned the division of revenue bill. And allow me to make this point, is that we have a division of revenue bill that has not been passed. The county governments had asked for an allocation of over 314 billion. And this will be monies that will cater. This is even without conditional grants, what he's mentioning in NHIF and the likes. And in what the National Assembly passed and they gave was 291 billion. Mm. The Council of Governors, the counties, let me say the counties, together with the Commission on Revenue Allocation, National Treasury, and Senate, their proposal will cater, will come to that around 314 billion, so as to cater for the...
Mr. Laibuta is giving here, unions were not supposed to sit down with the employer, negotiate for a CBA, and also help them look for money. As we sat, we have minutes, we negotiated, we agreed, we had evidences as to why we wanted what we wanted, and we have finished. I'm even shocked he's saying that we don't yet have a CBA. Mm-hmm. According to the people we were negotiating with, who are the employers, we negotiated the CBA and we finished. They should have been restless from the word go. Remember, we called off a strike. We didn't even call it off. I am sorry. I need to correct that. We suspended a strike on December 16th for 60 days. Then immediately it was called off. The crisis was over. Everybody went back to go and relax. They should have looked. We need to be proactive. They should have looked for this money. They should have said, Cabinet Secretary Treasury is saying that he's shocked the COG is not able to negotiate the allowances, and they were already given. Rotich should not think that we were going to take the 15,000, 20,000 that was given in January. That was just an allowance that was given, and we appreciated it for the efforts we put into healthcare in this country as nurses.
And
the rest was done through our proposal, which had very many items.
So, can you say that your employer totally didn't understand what you did?
They understood.
But then they understood there was somebody.
We were negotiating under the buildings of COG. The CEO COG was there in office every other day. She should have passed by to see what is it that you're cooking.
Because who was writing the figures?
Was it the union?
The union plus the employer.
You see, what happens is that the union, they put their demands on the table. Okay, with all the allowances plus maybe a review of salary, and the employer says, we have received your demands.
Mm-hmm.
We will look into them, all right, and then we'll get back to you. Give us some time.
Mm-hmm.
So they will sit down, look at what they can do, check how much they have, and then after checking what they have, then they would say, let's consult SRC before we do what? We get back to our employees. So when they come to SRC, we interrogate, we tell them, okay, you are ready to do this, yes. Do you have the money?
Which has not been answered yet.
Yes. Do you have the money?
Which has not been answered yet by them.
So we tell them, before you answer the money, this other thing, we have agreed on this one, do this one, do this one. Please, as you go back, these are the beacons. If you're going to negotiate with your employees, don't go beyond here, don't go beyond here. You can negotiate below, but don't go beyond. Our experience is that it went back, and they went beyond what was given as beacons. That was not brought to our attention as union.
I mean, because you seem to be defending the governors as well, the Council of Governors, and vilifying the nurses. And I'm just wondering, do you think there was a breakdown of communication from the governor's side?
My take
because
is that all these problems...
Did anything about beacons come back?
All these problems, the most problems we have are communication issues. It has nothing to do with what's going on. It's just how to communicate and get the information down. As I mentioned earlier, we are not understood. I'm not sure whether it's because we haven't communicated properly, because our role is so clear. We don't negotiate.
You advise.
We advise.
Yes.
Bring to the table. Let's see what you have. I will check what the other union is getting, the other one, the other institution, because we are dealing with all of the public service. Mm-hmm. Once we know what's going on, we then give you an advice that if you're going to negotiate, these are the beacons. We're not telling you give them 5%. We're saying, no. It's between 3 and 5 or 3 and 10.
Okay.
Just negotiate within that and see within your affordability. Once you're able to negotiate and agree, and once you agree now with the employer, you come and then we offer you a no objection to go and register the CBA.
And I'm sure people are wondering what these figures are, because it appears that maybe the nurses are asking for quite a lot. Can we just look at some of those figures?
I'm not sure whether it's even figures.
I mean, I don't know where the figures came from, but it's interesting to see that document
that
is going around and which is being discussed as the CBA that should have been signed between... between the nurses. And the Council of Governors. So maybe we can just look at the screen for 1 minute. So job groups. Current salary, we can see 35,000 for those job groups, and
that's an allowance.
And those are allowances.
Extraneous allowance.
Those are not salaries.
It was the extraneous allowance that was increased by 5,000.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is the other job group.
Yeah,
so these are what, monthly allowances or what?
Yes, every month.
Monthly allowance.
All right, and this is in the rural areas.
Yeah.
Why is that that differentiation between the rural areas?
Between the rural and the urban. This happened when we were still under national government.
Mm-hmm.
Remember when we had Minister of Public Health, Sanitation, Minister of Medical Services,
right,
and people in the rural areas were seen as who they had the heaviest. Brand.
Pardon?
Yeah.
So it's actually an additional 5,000 shillings every job group, yeah?
Yes.
And so where was the main contention? Was it in
not
this?
Not here.
Where was it, Mr.
Maybe Lander? SRC can tell us, or COG.
And we have
the
that.
Contention was. Because as far as we are concerned,
those are the figures
discussed
of,
and agreed.
What was
this
proposed?
Well, these are gross. This is gross
salaries. Salaries, right?
These are gross salaries, mm-hmm. and I'm not sure they will explain. I think it's important to look at the marginal request from the nurses.
Mm-hmm.
It is just beyond the gross, because basic pay, we are saying that we've just undertaken a job evaluation,
right,
and within that framework,
and on the same,
right, that
have
framework,
a question on the job evaluation.
We should be able to place them where they're supposed to be in terms of basic pay. But then in terms of allowances, there is what you call a number of increases. in all those allowances that had, been mentioned,
right.
That earlier, at least we did not, in terms of the discussion, we had given them direction, what they need to do and what we can be able to afford as we, where we are right now.
So that one, you gave it to the Council of Governors?
No, the employers, wrote to us, this is what we told them. That, you know, we are going to work on, first of all, the 20,000 was not even in your budget, so you'd have to explain how, first of all, you're going to meet that 20,000.
Okay. Which was done in December.
I think perhaps you need to explain where the 20,000 and 15,000, because Job Group G2L got 20,000 in the return to work formula, M to T, 15,000. And you remember when that was signed, county government said, hey, we really do not have these funds. But National Treasury came and said, we will look for funds and buffer you for six months.
Yes.
But you must look for these funds. And I said there are two ways to look for these funds. The equitable share of revenue between national and county, and secondly, counties raising their own revenue. So that is how this was worked out, the 20 and 15.
So you could afford it. Yeah.
At the moment, the 20 and 15 is already budgeted for, and the nurses will continue enjoying those allowances as per their return to work formula that was signed in December. Mm-hmm. That is not in dispute at all.
So what was the main thing in dispute? What was in dispute?
I mean, what I'm saying now is in dispute, and what I'm stating is that, one, there are several items. One is that we wish to have the nurses sit with us, mm-hmm. and discuss these matters.
But we have already sat to discuss.
Secondly, SRC has directed and said you must prove several issues. One, that you have the funds from the two streams that I've indicated, and two, it's not a one-off thing. It is sustainable. It will not be something you do for 1 year, then later you tell SRC, by the way, we cannot sustain this this income stream.
And when we understand that,
yes.
But just judging by Halima's demeanor, the nurses are not taking that for an answer.
We are not.
Are you willing to stay out of hospitals
for as long as
until
this is
the figures
one,
you want are
one,
implemented?
One chance. That we are not ready to squander.
Why,
just one chance.
Why are you saying one chance?
It
why
is
now?
So dear to us, because whatever allowance that is being denied for nurses is the health risk allowance.
Mm-hmm.
The risk nurses undergo at their workplaces.
How much is that? Is the health?
3,850. Mm-hmm. SRC is saying, apparently they're even setting the amounts. And he just said their role is to advise. So I'm wondering, are they advising and at the same time setting figures.
So you want it increased too?
We agreed with the employer. Yes. It wasn't a proposal. We had our proposal and
yes.
We negotiated and agreed with the people who were sent to us by government to negotiate, and we agreed at 15,400, equal to what the doctors were given. And if you compare the risk nurses undergo compared to the doctors, a research was done in our hospital, referral hospital, KNH, and it was discovered that nurses undergo risk 70 times any other health worker can undergo. So if we were not understanding, if we didn't give and take, we would have done the 20,000 that was given to the doctors times 70.
So,
but
we
said, just give us the percentage that was given to the doctors for now.
But in my view, what has happened here, if you look at it, and I'm looking at it from the perspective of the patients and everything else. This, like she says, there's the CBA that was written. Somewhere along the line it is on the out tray or still in the in tray of the necessary organizations. What the nurses have decided to do is that since you've not been listening to us, elections are around the corner.
Yeah.
This is the juiciest time to take advantage.
Apparently, it's not a coincidence. It has nothing to do with politics. No one has calculated anything. I am honest on this. No one has calculated anything. It has nothing to do with politics.
Let me ask
and
you.
If it has to do anything, if it has anything to do with politics, it is the government that has calculated.
But let me ask you. You made this comment that this is the one chance
you don't want to
squander.
Yeah, we don't.
What does that
because
mean?
Because we have walked the journey. Remember, our constitution is derived from the ILO conventions.
Right.
Where we have been given this right to collective bargaining agreement with them, between us and the employer. The employer here, being County Public Service Board Chair, I wish he was here. And we went, I wish SRC was in that sitting. I wish Mr. Laibuta and Jacqueline Mogeni were in that sitting, because it was very emotional and we walked through that journey. And eventually, the Chair's County Public Service Board understood where nurses were coming
from.
So
now your employer is saying, I'm sorry, we can't afford those.
Our employer has not said that. It is COG that has said that. But our employer is County Public Service Board.
But
and there's a letter they have written to SRC. And I think I can show you that letter, Asha. There's a letter that was written by the chair, and he said that the implementation of that CBA will be undertaken by an implementation committee where they can even, CBAs, it's not a one-off thing. When they say 40 billion, they should not just sit down and get overexcited about figures and throw us in the bins. They should look at that money and, like he said, look for money and see, these are a category of workers we cannot afford to lose. We cannot afford our patients to suffer. Where can we get this money?
So they're saying we want to go back to the drawing board.
We are not going back to the drawing board.
Mr. Monyoncho, what happens, because we are seeing this is the push and pull that the public doesn't get to see, and that's how the strike drags on. Now entering 10th day tomorrow.
Yep.
So, I mean, what is the solution then?
For me, it doesn't have to be this way. We don't have to walk the route of the strike. It doesn't help. It has never helped. I think it's important to sit around the table and agree. Sometimes the Englishman saying one bird in hand is worth two in the bush is worth it, and you start walking the process.
Is that what you're telling the nurses?
Well, I'm not telling the nurses that anything. I'm not telling them anything. I'm just telling them as they negotiate, let them look at what is available. Okay? What is available and what can be given? If you're increasing your allowance threefold, so what are you saying? Because from our perspective,
right.
No, and there's a category of workers that has already been increased for threefold.
The health risk.
What makes us different?
Let him finish.
The health risk, we're saying that we gave a range where they can be able to meet 5, you.
5,000.
Range. We didn't even give 5,000. That's what they decided to take the maximum.
Okay,
yes,
so can we probably like wrap this up?
Yes.
Because our time is running out.
Yeah.
What is the solution, please, Mr. Kamau?
I can give a solution in 3 points.
One
the national...
Merge them into one, probably.
Yeah. The national government needs to set the necessary standards and guidelines on dealing with the health issues across the country. Two, the counties, through the COG...
Yes.
Should come up with minimum standards and guidelines on dealing with the health issues across the country.
And finally,
the SRC should be fair in its review of salaries and remunerations.
Okay.
If the wage bill is high,
right,
as they say, they should first of all deal with those guys in Parliament whose salaries are above.
We've understood that. So, Mr. Laibuta, maybe wrapping words very briefly.
Yeah, from where I sit, as I said, request our colleagues from the union back to the table. We've been having very cordial discussions in good faith. They didn't sign a return to work formula. They were very instrumental during their 100-day their 100-day strike. And we're saying, we're in this for the long haul. And Evolution is here with us. We have advice from all these institutions. And all we are requesting, let's sit down, let's come up with a CBA. That will be saying that
so
is
go
one.
So go back to
yes,
the
Yes, that is all we're requesting. And also beseeching them to go back on duty, look at how Kenyans are suffering. We do understand their plight.
I'm sorry, I have to cut you short.
Yes.
Unfortunately, our time is up. But we've had all your thoughts, and hopefully maybe we'll see our discussion probably tomorrow on this so that we can end this stalemate. Thank you for watching the roundtable. You can join the